Sowing choices are critical, which is why the National Variety Trials data is a must-see resource for grain growers. New NVT and State Department sowing guides are available to help growers make informed varietal selections. These three cereal specialists are part of the team that puts that data together.
Looking at the NVT results for wheat varieties, we're seeing a number of varieties are performing well across 4 years. One such variety would be Suntop. It's been averaging 4 to 5% across most regions above Gregory, so it's something growers maybe want to look at. This year, we need to look at a number of things in our farming system. Last year, crown rot was a big issue, so growers need to look at their wheat varieties, look at their farming systems and their paddocks, and decide, is it going to be important? And look to choose a variety that will be able to tolerate crown rot or give them the highest yield possible in the presence of crown rot. Now, one variety, SunGuard, it's been around for a number of years, has one of the highest ratings in terms of crown rot tolerance. So it's an option for growers to grow a specific variety or choose a variety that has some tolerance to something like crown rot. Growers need to talk to their agronomists about stripe rust and make sure any new variety has a rating at least equivalent or better than their current variety. Growers also need to understand that there are different forms of resistance. We have seedling resistance, which they're used to in terms of Gregory, where we see protection right through the season. But a lot of the new varieties have adult plant resistance. The growers need to be aware early in the season they may need to help those varieties with fungicide to make sure they've got a clean, healthy crop going through the season. The other disease that's been popping up through central and northern New South Wales and growing important is this root lesion nematode. It's something a lot of growers don't realise it's there. It's just nibbling away at their profits and bringing back their yields. There are a number of new varieties like Suntop, Gauntlet, that have reasonable resistance and tolerance levels to this disease, and growers should look to move to those and avoid any susceptible varieties. What we're seeing, there are a number of new varieties that have improved grain quality gradings. A lot are coming out now with Australian Prime Hard Classification. Now that's important for growers when they're looking at different varieties. They need to make sure that they're not going backwards in terms of their grade classification, because at the end of the day, it's dollars returned to those growers. New varieties like Lancer, Suntop, and Gauntlet in the north all have Prime Hard status, so they're good options if they want to move away from Gregory. Similarly, Spitfire has a Prime Hard grading.
Mace dominated plantings last year and we don't expect that to change in 2014. However, a leaf rust pathotype was discovered in WA last year, which may have an impact on the resistance ratings of mace to leaf rust. So, growers should be budgeting for fungicide in those rust-prone areas. Korak, Cobra and Emu Rock were released a couple of years ago. Korak is a high-yielding APW. However, Black Point and Powdery Mildew are risk factors for that variety. Cobra is an AH variety and it performs better in the high rainfall and with May sowings. Sprouting is a risk factor for that variety. Emu Rock is an AH variety also, earlier maturing and more suited to the low rainfall area and with competitive with mace, it yields up to around 2 ton potential. Harper and Trojan were released last year and have the potential to be Yip Pea replacements. Harper is an APW, slightly earlier maturing than Yip Pea, with similar sprouting and Black Point ratings. However, Powdery Mildew is a risk factor for that variety. Trojan is not classified at this point in time. Its maturity is similar to Magenta, and we see it having a better fit in the medium to high rainfall area.
Based on the trends of grower receivals the last couple of years, mace is clearly going to be the most dominant variety grown in South Australia this year. It looked probably more than 50% of the area, and that's quite good, and it's quite concerning from some respects. In terms of its performance, mace is definitely one of the highest performing varieties, yield-wise and quality-wise in South Australia, and it means growers have really latched onto a highly profitable variety. But at the same time, mace is very susceptible to stripe rust, and growers just need to be very aware that has to be monitored very carefully and vigilantly. So. Mace will certainly be further adopted, but there are other varieties coming through at the moment through the breeding programs and being commercialised that will that will take some of the segment of mace, and I'm talking specifically about Korak, which has been one of the leading varieties in national variety trials across South Australia for the last 2 years. Slightly higher yielding than mace, but of lower quality. And that will be one variety that growers will have a lot of interest in. There's also Emu Rock, which is an Australian hard variety as well, but a little bit lower yielding than mace. It will be of interest to growers. There are a couple of other varieties such as Trojan and Cobra, which are probably more adapted to the higher rainfall zones, the higher yielding areas of South Australia, and certainly there will be growers that will be looking at those varieties. The bulk of these varieties are Australian hard, so they fit the quality parameters we need. The bulk of these varieties have CCN, cereal earworm resistance, which is also important in South Australia, and they have good stem rust resistance, which has been an issue with some of our older varieties being susceptible, such as Yitpi. So these varieties cover off on a number of new aspects, and they will be taken up to some degree, but mace will still continue to dominate for some time. The information on all these varieties can be found on the NVT Online website, nvtonline.com.au, but it's also encompassed within publications which SARDI put out each year, the Harvest Report, and that contains a lot of information, detailed information about yields, quality, where varieties specifically perform well, and I'd encourage growers to look at that as well.